Yo, what up, though? It's your boy OT from the D, and welcome to another installment of the Hip Hop Fifth Element. You know what I mean? Fifth Element Hip Hop. You know what I mean? No matter how you say it, backwards or forwards, it always sounds great. You know what I mean? Where we represent hip hop in its truest form. That's peace, love, unity, and having fun. And, you know, same as always. We got some dope-ass special guests in the house today.
Yeah, yeah.
But before we get into that...
Hip-hop is in the building.
Let me go ahead and introduce my co-host, Ray-Mo, a.k.a. Ray Sun. What up, though?
What it do, man? Another week, no smut on our names.
Last time that I checked.
Right? Man, how y'all feeling?
You know what I mean? We chilling, man. You know what it is.
Let's get with it, then.
And sitting next to Ray-Mo is my other lovely co-host.
Look how we matching. Look at us.
You know what I'm saying? The lovely Supreme Kai Senpai.
Y'all know. You know what Supreme Kai Senpai, Drip Dry Kai, follow the drip.
Yes, sir. Drip, yes, sir.
Drip,
yes, sir.
This Tokyo Ghoul drip for y'all this week.
You know what I'm saying? And in the back there, y'all see who it is. Your DJ's favorite DJ. Y'all know who he is. The incredible DJ Slim.
My brother.
Peace, peace, y'all.
You know what I mean? And over there, chilling out with the bucket hat. Bucket book.
Super cool.
Bucket book. Hollywood book.
Too cool.
What's up, y'all?
There you go.
All that. You know what I mean?
Let me get my whole what's up.
You know what I mean? Hey, you know the mic pick up your voice, right, Book? All you gotta do is just say what's up.
Book on damn that.
He's like, nah, fuck that. You know what I mean? I gotta hold it. I gotta make sure I'm hurt. Hey, look, I hear you, Book. I ain't even knocking you, man. Do what you gotta do. Get your shine.
Don't knock the hustle.
You know what I'm saying? Straight up. So, Ray-Mo, man, what's up, baby? Everything good, man? What we got today?
Everything good, but we got something different for today, man. We got to start the show off way different.
Okay. I'm like, you're sitting next to me right now, joining us for this installment of the Fifth Element. You know what I mean? Special little thing we got y'all
special
doing.
Special bar test.
You know what I'm saying?
Yes,
we got
he's back.
My man,
he's
back. Cease Loco. All
right, let me
Loco.
Get this shit right.
You know what I'm saying? And he about to go in here and hit y'all with a little test in the beginning.
Let's get this shit.
You know what I'm saying? Yo, Slim, let's
go
see
in.
What we do. Six, tell them what up.
Look.
Big Scoon.
Big Scoon.
Big Scoon. All right, here we go. Yo. Oh, yes. John only came for the bar testing to show y'all who's not fresh. Bear my soul every time I bar for the mic, cause I'm always nauseous. Bar none, he's far apart from most of these cats who are rapping. You ask them to spark something, you'll find they got bars none. They might charge though, if you asking me, here's my honest view. MCs front like they're gangsters with first names like Bartholomew. In between this is obviously a large distance. I'm from Vegas where the alcohol flows, so you know I stay bartending. The barbarian, y'all bars barely shift the barometer. Charred crews when I'm cooking, y'all are fooled. I'm a barbecue them. I'm hardly moved by these piss poor poets who shouldn't rap. I pray to hit some effective snatch bare back and catch a rare clap that's incurable. They're not durable, horrible with their bars, kid. I'm God tier. We could go 72 rounds of bare knuckle boxing. I advise caution. I'd much rather be finding out of Barbie's thoughts than be concerned with conversations ranking me at a barbershop. Bear witness to a menace to the instruments working who gets down similar to how barbiturates turn moves. Sour devour cowards with a stereo smack, which y'all get props to. For me equals a barrel of laughs, finding behind these bars like an inmate in a dimly lit dive bar, sipping liquor, trying to sit straight, pouring out a wedlock, so you know that the bar sinister. Came to set the bar high. When I rhyme, I got bar penmanship. Bomb.
And that's it.
Hey,
that's Cease Loco
right
there.
I did what I came to do, and now I'm out.
Cease Loco, man. Hey, certified on the bar test, man. You know what I mean? Y'all know what it is.
One half of lethal repping.
One half of lethal repping, man. And I'm like, damn. You know what I'm saying?
That
I'm
just
like,
happened.
That
all
really
those
just
bars.
You know
did y'all
mean?
Get all those bars?
I'm like, man, you know
did y'all get all those bars? I don't know if y'all got all of them, but I know, I mean, like, there was a lot of bars.
Right. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, man.
On purpose.
Tell a friend, sheesh. Subscribe to the Fifth Element Hip Hop YouTube. That's how we coming.
www.fifthelementhiphop.com.
We got bars. We got bars for y'all.
ElementHipHop.com.
We got that, you know. Other than our lovely faces, we got hip hop. That's the selling point of the show is the hip hop. Okay.
Yes, sir. So Now that Cease Loco done set it off for us right there.
Right.
You know what I mean? We're going to jump right on into our one of our guests of the day that we get to interview right now. I'm like, I was put on alert to this guy by Supreme Kai Senpai. You know what I mean? She brought him to the table and been campaigning for this man for like the last couple months.
Right.
Like, yo, you got to listen to this
that
dude.
Part.
You got to. You got to. And
I'm 6 months, right, easily. Right,
shout out, Kai.
Easy. 6 months. You know what I mean? And we would have had him up a little earlier, but, you know, conflicting schedules didn't allow it. You know what I mean? But, you know, look at God. You
we
know,
here now.
We here now. And things have fell into place. And right now I get to... welcome to the Fifth Element family, my guy, A-Hi. Hey,
yo.
You know what I'm saying?
What's happening? What's happening?
Hey, man.
Vegas, what's good? Welcome with you, Fifth Element?
The
what's
up with you, man? Appreciate it. Appreciate
it. Feels good to be here, man.
Thank
appreciate
you. Thank you. Thank you, man. I'm like, yo, so A-Hi, man, tell the people a little bit about yourself, man.
A-Hi, born in Chicago.
Okay.
Sort of a hybrid, raised between Chicago and the Bay Area.
Oh shit! You know,
Northern
Bay.
California. So,
oh,
okay,
yeah,
so
diverse.
I've been back and forth my whole life. So,
okay,
I think my style and you know my structure and everything, how I go about music, it's kind of a balance between the two.
Where you at in the Bay?
I was in Concord, so close.
Concord. Okay.
So North Bay.
Okay.
Basically, I'm closer to Oakland.
Okay.
Than I was
to
San
Oakland.
Francisco.
Okay.
Yeah. So
dope.
Yeah. It's like one of them little small suburbs. Like
Right.
Yeah, but you know Oakland and Frisco, them like the two biggest ones. So.
Right.
Yeah,
so that's crazy.
I was over the bridge by Oakland.
We gonna be up that way next week, man.
Oh,
Sacramento.
Oh, yeah, y'all going to Sac.
I'm like, it's about to be crazy up there, man.
The weather just like it is out here, too.
Okay. Oh,
ain't no different. Yeah, it's hot as hell.
It ain't 100. Is it 108?
It's about that. Yeah.
I was hoping I was about to get a break.
Nah, where do we need to go? Like, where does Fifth Element need to go when they out there in the Bay? Like, what's the thing?
So they got that Indian summer type of thing. It comes like a lot later, you know what I'm saying? But Sac is always hot.
Jeez.
Like, so you want to go towards the water, low key.
Word
up. Be like cool, you know what I'm
saying? Look, San Francisco be cold in the summertime.
That's what I'm saying. It's I'm 65, like,
you
70.
You need a jacket
you
know in the summertime.
Yeah,
in
as soon
Francisco.
As the sun go down, you need a hoodie or some
for real,
shit.
Though. Yeah. For real, I've been before.
I'm like, man, it's a
bipolar.
Few cats out there in the Bay Area making noise right now, man.
Oh, absolutely.
I've been campaigning these guys on this dude, LaRussell Forever, man.
Okay.
I'm like, yo, so I'm like, okay. I know you heard of him.
I heard of him. Yeah, I heard of him.
He's like that.
Like these last few years, man, like it's been real hard for me to really keep up with so much music that's coming
right.
out. There's so many artists that's popping.
Right.
You know what I'm
right.
saying? So it's like if it's not somebody that's telling me like, yo, check out such and such, you know what I'm saying? Then it's like, yo, it might go over my head for
right,
me.
Right,
until,
right, right.
Or I'm usually late to the party. You know what I'm saying? I end
right.
up finding out about them, but I'm late to the party. But, you know, when you independent artist, you're doing your thing. You know what
right.
I'm saying? Obviously, you have your favorites that you definitely going to check for when they drop. But
right.
other than that, man, I'm in the lab, bro. I'm working, so I don't really have time to.
So
as crazy as that sounds, like I be trying to listen to as much shit as I can, but I be working, man.
So being a hybrid, all the way from Chicago to the Bay Area, when did you move out to the Bay Area, and what Bay Area music started to influence
so
the way you approach music?
So the first, I believe, my father was a Marine,
okay,
so that's what brought us, you know, out this way.
Okay,
and then I want to say I was like three.
He was three
or four.
Okay.
And my OG, my mama, you know, growing up, she didn't want me listening to, you know, any cursing and anything like that. So,
man, too short is
that's what I'm saying. No, she hey, she can only shield me for so long. But it was crazy. Like, my introduction to rap was actually my father.
Oh,
my
nice.
Dad was a rapper. So,
okay.
Yeah, he went by Black Ice, Roman Empire.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Changed his name a couple times.
Dope,
you know what I'm saying?
Dope,
but,
dope.
That's
when I was a shorty, he wrote my first, that was my first time in the studio watching him. My first rhyme that I ever ripped, he wrote it for me. You know what I'm saying? So I was about seven.
Damn.
You know what I'm saying, when I started. So
okay,
that was kind of
okay.
like my introduction. But yeah, 40 Water, Rapping Forte, Richie Rich, you know what I'm saying? Too Short, all them came like
Too
right after, bro. Like
right.
as soon as I like got exposed to hip hop and just the music and the feel of it, you know what I'm saying? Then
right.
from there it was lit.
Yeah, I mean, I always love Bay Area rap, man. I always thought
it's different, man.
It's got that swag.
It's
different. Got that style.
That hyphy movement was something. I was in college during that hyphy movement.
Yeah,
that shit
went
was
up
crazy.
Hyphy movement.
Man, we was partying, yo.
That was like coast to coast. No matter who you was, when you heard it, it was like,
this
what
man
is
right
this?
Here, had a hyphy set.
Yeah.
That every DJ in the city copied. When I say every DJ in the city copied that, am I lying, Slim?
On me.
Everybody took that dude hyphy set.
Rest in peace, Mac Dre, man.
Man, Mike Dre, man.
Rest in peace, Dre, man.
Man, look. Feeling Myself is still one of my all-time favorite songs.
And you know what? You know what's crazy, right? Is Seven is a youngster, right?
Mm-hmm.
He be playing that. He be playing that like it's brand new. He was like, "Dad, you ever heard this?" I was like, "Boy, this is Mac Dre. Right? What are you talking about?
You're
right.
You're not putting me on.
It's fun party music. You know what I'm saying? Yep. So it's like get out there, enjoy yourself. Like obviously they had the references for drugs and all that shit, but you know, man, that's either for you or it's not. But outside of that, man, listen to the beats and the, you know what I'm saying? Trax A Million was killing like everything.
Trax A Million,
you know what I'm saying? Yeah, like it's they official, bro.
So go ahead, Ray.
I'm not a big hyphy man.
Yeah,
I'm not a big hyphy fan.
I go dumb.
It's one of the things.
I go dumb. And I'm from Jersey, so that's saying a lot.
It's an acquired taste.
Yeah, I got a couple, you know, E40 when you go dumb and a couple of hits here and there. But big time, nah.
Yeah, see, I
feel you.
I was a hyphy dude, man. I like that.
I feel it.
Everything ain't for everybody.
No,
definitely. You know, that's really all it is.
So being out there, man, I'm like, I know they like to be in their cars and stuff like that, man, out there. And they be doing the, what they call it, the side shows. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Where they be doing the donuts in the joints or whatever. Man,
ghost riding the whip.
You ever get into any of that?
Hell to the nah, bro. I done seen too many people, motherfucking, just innocent bystanders.
Getting
that motherfucker, whoop.
Yeah, I've seen that. It's tragic.
It's one of my favorite hood movies. It's a movie called Kicks.
Okay.
Right. That's it. Then they filmed it out in the bay or whatever, whatever. And it's about that. And it's a scene in there where they doing the sideshow and the dude get hit with a car and kills him and shit. And I was like, damn. And I was like, that's crazy.
That's real
I never
life.
Thought about that happening.
That's real life.
Because all we seen was the videos.
That's real
and
life.
And them going up.
That's why they try to shut them down. Because a lot of people, like, why they doing their thing in the middle? Mm-hmm. You know, niggas running in with cameras and, you know what I'm saying? Just trying
to
get the best footage and they getting too close. And the driver, you know, he
just whipping.
Yo, he whipping, yo. He ain't looking to see who left and right. Like, you know what I'm saying? So, yeah, I think the last, just a month ago, I saw somebody got hit. Like, a month ago.
Damn.
It was recent.
Dude, he got slid.
Yeah.
Look man, hey, it's too many devices to have to get close. All you got to do is get an extension pole.
I'm about to say a selfie stick, my guy.
Selfie stick, hold that joint out.
Yo, like,
a 10-foot joint, you know what I mean?
There you go.
That's it, yo.
Nice and safe.
Technology didn't come up with you. You ain't got to be in the mix.
You could be in a selfie and the whole thing. Right. Like with the, I don't know why they feel they got to get up right on the, you know what I'm saying, the license plate, but yo.
They want to jump in there with the lion and shit and take a picture of his teeth.
That part, OD.
Yo, you want to get that close, just get in the passenger seat.
Straight up.
Just get in the car.
Yeah, man.
Like, man, then you could be an accessory to murder. You can be an accessory to manslaughter.
Me,
straight up.
Just like that, yeah. That's facts, man. That's facts, though.
Crazy, crazy,
so,
crazy.
But, like, what's like, okay, I mean, obviously you grew up pretty much with hip-hop in your blood,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
So, like, what's the hip-hop that, you know, you can't live without, like, right now? Like, I mean, what's the things, like, you know, that keep you going, keep you doing what you do?
Honestly, so born in 85, you know, civilized 85er.
right.
Yo, I gotta say, like, the cast that these youngins would consider old is the ones that's like still pushing the needle for me. Like Nas and Hit-Boy, like Nas is like
that last Nas and Hit-Boy album,
Grammy Award win.
Come on, yo,
that, like, shit was so crazy.
Just listening to him and like, yo, this is still classic vintage 90s Nas, but it's just on updated beats, you know what I'm saying?
So,
but the lyricism, like the bars, like that's still him, you know what I'm saying? So I'm seeing a lot of artists now that, you know, they kind of, you know, rebranding and, you know, they keeping their flow and things the same because that's what made you, you know what I'm saying? But I guess just working with younger producers and getting those more, you know what I'm saying, like those beats for today,
that's all they
ripping
doing
that shit,
you know?
And man, that's I'm having
and
fun
it,
with
and
that
it still
so.
Works though.
Yeah, it
you know,
works
I'm
it
like,
works
it works because
but it's the thing, you got bars
exactly.
You know what I'm saying? So it's like, yo, if you rap and you really do this shit, then you do this, you know what
all
I'm saying?
So I'm like, let's get into these albums though, man. I'm like, yo, I was peeping out Concord Greens and the Cake Tape, Appreciate you both. Both of them are ridiculous. I like the cake tape because it's like a mixtape. Yeah. Nobody does a mixtape no more. Yeah, so it's a Valentine's Day mixtape.
It's a Valentine's Day tape.
Right. Yeah. I'm telling y'all, like when I first heard the cake tape, that's when I was like, I gotta have him on the show.
That shit was just like, you know, the idea just came in shit like January, probably the middle of January, and I'm like, all right, I got a month to get this down. But I had already been compiling. I keep a note of just old school beats and just anything that I come across. I'm like, I got to touch that shit.
You come up with that in a month?
Yeah.
That's an official jacket for beats.
So, official jacket for beats.
Right. Yeah, for real.
Yeah, and it's, crate digging and it's all
the time.
Too.
Crate digging all the time. So, yeah, when the tape, you know, when I came up with the idea for the tape, it was like, all right, let's not just throw out a bunch of songs where I'm just remixing them.
Right.
Let's tell a story. Right. So if you really listen to that joint, it start off as if I'm single. And I'm in the club, and then I meet a chick, and we go through the motions all the way through.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? So the tape itself tells a story. Going to the top. You know what I'm saying?
And it's when I say it's a good listen, man, y'all check it out, man. A-High. It's on YouTube only because it's a mixtape.
Yeah, right.
Because you can't get it on
iTunes. I couldn't do it on the iTunes.
On Tidal and everywhere.
I wouldn't even try to do that shit. They wouldn't even see the light of day, bro. They would cut that.
Yeah.
Instantly.
But it's on YouTube. Y'all check it out, man. It's a really good listen.
Got it on
man.
The SoundCloud as well.
SoundCloud.
Audio, so I could rip it on
there. I ain't even check for it on SoundCloud, man.
It's on the SoundCloud.
I was just like, you know what? I'm going to just have to deal with these commercials.
You know what I mean?
Yo, straight it's up. Worth it, man.
Yeah, man.
That shit amazing. Crazy, man. I'm
I
like,
appreciate
yo.
It, man.
So Concord Greens, man. Let's talk about that.
To bring it back, when I, you know, moved to California,
right.
My father was a Marine, we was in Concord.
Right.
And that was the name of the community housing that we lived in. It's Concord Greens. So that big, huge white dude that's with me, his name's Bobby California, Robert Patrick.
Yeah.
I grew up with him.
Yeah, and I see them. It'll be enlisted on the album,
too. Yeah, so he produced all the joints on it.
Nice.
Yeah, them all his beats.
Okay.
Dang, his beats is crazy.
And the thing is, when we was growing up, you know, he moved before I really started, you know, getting into it, or before I even knew that he made beats.
Right.
And so we kind of lost contact for, I want to say, like a decade, man.
Damn.
And then somewhere like in my early 20s, we kind of reconnected, and I was doing a cypher here in L.A., and then from there, I started flying back and forth. I was in Chicago at the time. So I'm flying back and forth, you know, to see him. He stayed in Marina Del Rey. And I'm like, bro, your beat's cold. And he's like, man, you rap? Like, let's do this shit. So from there, we was like, all right, this is it.
Then, hey, it's like the perfect marriage. You got beats, I got rhymes. Let's
pretty
go.
Much. And then we come from the same place. So it's like, when we put on, we're going to call it Concord Greens. This is
dope.
The name soil. Of the community housing. This is the soil where we came from. You
dope,
know what I mean?
Dope, yeah, so. Dope. I'm like, man, the album is dope too, man. I'm like, I listened to the whole thing.
Appreciate it.
I was knocking it all day today.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? Trying to see what's to you.
Different joints on there. You know what I'm saying?
It's real dope, man.
Like,
it's real dope.
But that one is like, we didn't really have a cohesive theme or anything that we was pushing for. It was like, at that point, it's like, let's just show versatility, bro.
Mm-hmm.
So give me a slow joint, give me a fast joint, give me some off the wall shit. You know what I'm saying? And basically, we just picked six different random that have nothing to do with nothing.
It's funny because I was like, you know, I'm listening to your flow and I can hear influences from different artists. Like, I can hear the Kendrick in it.
Yes.
I can hear the...
you about to name all my favorite
dude. You know what I mean?
I already know, bro.
I can hear the Kendrick in it. I can hear the swag of like the E-40s and, you know what I mean? The Bay Area influence. Yeah. And I can hear, like, you know, like from some Chicago in it.
Yes, sir.
You know what I mean? I can hear all of that in it. I was like, man, I was like, oh, I like this dude's
flow,
man.
No, it's crazy, man. Living in both places is... When I go to Chicago, because, you know, I've spent half my life in California, they hear the Bay Area slang and how I talk.
Right.
When I'm, you know, in the Bay or whatever, or in Chicago. Same when I'm in the Bay.
Right. They hear it.
I don't sound like I'm in the Bay. I sound like I'm from Chicago. So that's why I say I'm a hybrid. Because it's depending on where I'm at, I don't even fit the scope of, you know what I'm saying, where I'm going and shit. But I pull from both places, man. They made me, you know, who I am.
But, you know, it's like some of the... best MCs I felt like came from Chicago and from the Bay Area. Some people,
absolutely.
You know, we was just out here talking with Schoon and them about Spice One.
Yeah.
And like Spice One was like one of our favorite Bay Area rapper.
Legend.
I'm like, you know, I moved out here in 92 and my tape deck was Second to None, Spice One. and Common Sense. Those was my three joints right there. Yeah. Breaker 1-9, Peace to My Nine, and freaking what was that? So Basil Spice One, Common Sense.
Second to None, you said.
No, Second to None. Yeah, Second to None. If you want
yo,
it.
That Common.
If you want
you know
it.
What I mean?
Yo, the Common Resurrection album.
Oh, the second one? Yeah.
Crazy.
Like Water for Chocolate.
B is my favorite.
No ID produced. Yeah. Oh, man, that Communism.
Man.
That beat, though, Kanye did that one.
Bruh, he's the litmus test, you know what I'm saying, in Chicago still.
Yeah.
Like, maybe not for the youngins, because, you know, they more on Keith and Dirk.
Yeah, they on
the drill. Shout out to the drill scene, man, in Chicago for, you know what I'm saying, burping that shit, man. It's crazy to see where it's at now, but.
You ever be on YouTube, like just surfing sometimes?
Every now and then.
Okay, they got a cat out in Chicago named Corporate.
You know
Corporate, right?
My cousin's in. Went to school with him, man. I got people who went to school with that kid.
Hey, man, when I say, dude, his videos is one of the funniest
hell,
shits
bro.
Ever.
He like, funny as hell, bro.
I be dying laughing. I be waiting for his videos to drop.
Yeah,
so
man.
I'm like, yo, so since you watched
the show. You put me on because I didn't know. I never knew.
When you go to Chicago, do you eat at some of the places he advertised on the thing?
Oh, yeah. I've been to Jerk 48 a couple times.
So all I want to do is go to Jerk 48,
yeah,
man.
Yeah. I mean, I heard y'all talking about Harold's.
Yeah, Harold's.
But you got to go to the original,
They got Harold's in Green Valley Ranch out here now.
Stop lying.
I don't know. Is it the same? I
couldn't tell you.
See, they opened one in, I'm not going to hold you, they opened one in Hollywood in L.A.
Mm-hmm.
And I think I just got to L.A. I've probably been here a couple days. And I heard that there was one on the down the street from the Walk of Stars.
Nice.
I'm like, all right, let me go ahead and just put it, take some pictures. You know what I'm saying? I'm a tourist and shit. And I go in there, bought that shit about $16.
Mm. Right.
Took maybe 3 or 4 bites of that shit and threw it away, man.
Best thing about it was the white bread.
I told her bread and the fries, salt and pepper, extra mild sauce. I tore that shit up. But the chicken, and get this tough ass shit up out of here, man.
Ooh,
yes. Right. Hey, that's that Chicago talking shit. You know, get this shit up out of here, man.
Hey, man. Right. Yo, I was like, I don't know what y'all doing. Who overcooked the chicken? Yo? I don't know how you do that.
Damn.
Yeah, that's the whole thing you're supposed to be doing.
Yo.
Look, I wanted to ask you about on the Concord Greens, the new energy joint with Fauci. Like, what?
Yeah.
Like, what?
That's.
Like, that's, I think that's my favorite song on there. I think that's my favorite song.
Yeah, that joint is hot, man. Mine's is TNA.
Okay.
That's a joint, though.
That's the dark horse. That was my dark horse. I was like, look, this the one that don't fit no type of scope or nothing, bro. It's just, you know what I mean?
Yeah, and you know.
I'm listening to TNA. I'm like, okay.
Telling stories.
You know, I like TNA, too, because TNA, like the beat to it and the hook, it's like real kind of Dilla-esque. You know how Dilla would do that thing where he would like put the words, but it's not what it's saying.
Yeah.
But because you're like listening for that, that's what you hear.
Yeah.
That's what I got from it. It was dope.
Yeah.
I loved
it. The new energy joint, honestly, that's Bobby's doing.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I think he had the beat ready. He already hooked up with Fu. You know what I'm saying? They had the chorus on there already. And he's like, yo, just, I got this one. Let's hop on it. And I was like, all right.
I also like the story on Thirsty Thursday.
Yeah, that's a good one, too.
The story on Thirsty Thursday was freaking dope.
Shout out to Abstract Mind, yo. So when I sent him the reference, I had already, you know, the hook's already done.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I did my verse already. And I threw it to him.
Right.
You know, and obviously my shit, I'm talking about having a girl Monday through Wednesday.
Right, Monday through Wednesday.
And it's like, man, on Thursday, I miss her, yo. Like, I know you with your guy, but I'm going to call you anyway.
But he flipped it.
He flipped it, bro.
That's what was dope.
He took it from Thursday to Sunday.
Exactly.
It was like, why she don't, like, we cool on these days, but why don't talk to her Monday through Wednesday?
Yeah, right. I don't know how I feel about
called
this.
Him, I called him, I said, nigga, you a genius, bro. Yeah, right. I love how you flipped that, bro.
Flipped
I said, you a
and
genius,
I was like,
boy.
I was like, damn, this shit is dope.
It's a whole nother level to it. Like, he added a whole nother level to it.
Like real talk, man, I was listening to it, man, and it got me, like, after I heard, you know, Thirsty Thursday, the second song. So, you know, the first song you listen to, and you're like, okay, this thing. Thirsty Thursday, I was like, okay, damn, this is dope. Then I heard the new energy, and I was like, okay. But then TNA, I was like, all right, man, I'm listening to the whole album. Bro. I was just like,
running. That's what I mean.
I was just like, running back, man. I'm like,
my
keep
man.
Going, man.
My man, I
was
appreciate
like, man,
that, man.
Every song on there, man, was lit, man. I definitely...
Long way coming, man. Like, it's one thing to know how to write, but I'm really starting to, you know, learning, try to get better at structuring songs and really putting like actual songs together.
Right, you know what I'm saying?
And so, I mean, things is progressing. There's a couple companies I've actually wrote some jingles for.
Nice.
A couple cats I'm ghostwriting for. Nice. One is a comedian.
Okay.
So it's like some funny rapping shit. So it's like my head now and what I get to do is I get to jump in a lot of different bags. You know what I'm saying? So it keeps my shit sharp.
Yeah, keep it sharp.
So
that's dope. Keep your hand in all them pockets. Yeah,
speaking of sharpness, you know what I'm saying? I'm like, you know, this is a hip hop show, right? You know what I mean?
I know that.
And we, you know, anytime anybody get up here and talk about throwing their darts, you know what I'm saying?
I'm prepared.
We always got a little something for them.
Absolutely.
You know what I mean? Where they can, a dartboard they can shoot at.
Absolutely.
You feel me?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
So I'm like, yo, hey, Slimbo, what you got back there, baby? You know what I'm saying? Okay.
Yeah.
Hey, y'all, yeah, if y'all ain't know, man, y'all in for a treat, man. Y'all give it up for my guy, A-High. He about to eat on the bar test. What up?
Yeah, I wrote y'all a piece for this one, man, so I'm going off the phone on this.
Let's do it.
Shoot. Do what you do, baby.
Off this beat?
Oh, yeah. For the hip-hop heads, y'all know what it is. Hey. You gotta feel it.
Yeah, that's dope as fuck.
Hey,
already.
So y'all already know Auntie Mary, she, you know, she be having them long intros because she got that bop, so she got to get her shit off. So I was like, I ain't even going to interrupt Auntie Mary, you know what I'm saying? We going to talk our shit. Fifth Element, hip-hop, Vegas, what it do? Chicago in the building, man. Y'all know what it is. I go by the name A-High. We're going to let the beat breathe for a second.
How can I?
Yeah.
Stop.
To be happy, that's all we want, right?
That's what it's all about.
Let me talk to him. Yo, they'll switch up on you like bitches or bottom of knife pitches. Praying my light flicker, stay in the right scripture. Lay up at night, stare at the ceiling, mixed feelings, hoping they feeling me slight. Nah, there's no end in his sight, nigga, this me. Been doing this before the Sega made a Genesis. Finding ways to formulate my metaphors to sentences. Now I'm 0-3, Bron with the finishes. Competing, winning since. Non-believers, nah, they witnesses. The fifth element, but still they try to question it. Push the pen, is pointing towards excellence. I made it out the wilderness like Moses led his people through the Exodus. Niggas seem impressed by my success, but I expected this. City on my back, I'm something they believe in. You flavorless, competing with rappers that's highly seasoned. Got a lot of tree in my garden, I call it Eden. Didn't have no snakes in my yard till I let Eve in. Damn, I'm still healing from old wounds. Keep the punches coming, Iron Mike or the Pro Tools. A warning to the youngins, all that mumbling's old news. Been hungry for that real when it considered a soul food, ayy. Falling back off ain't even possible. I'm changing up the game, so we already called an audible. Not to confuse us with the losers y'all be talking to. They tripping off that little shit we hurdle in the obstacle. 20, 50, hundreds, women numbers, keep a pocket full. You playing pocket full, we gotta probably run in pockets too. Fuck all that talking, I ain't packing but my partner do. Finish stomping, dude, there's no one left to call but Dr. Who. Never stagnant, all I know is that I got to move. They see we made a way where others say it was impossible. Failure's not an option, don't let them haters bother you. Back against the wall, still swinging, got a lot to lose. The ones who hope to kill your dreams already dug the plot for you. Faint of heart, you and your feelings, homie, this is not for you. Chicago is an honor, rep the city, that's what I'ma do. That's on the dead, homies, and I put it on your mama too. But when your loved ones do your worst, then a stranger will. The pain is real, every day I feel the anger still. I'm moving targets, so my aim is on a major deal. This ain't a drill, use my pen to zero in, I aim to kill. And niggas changing up this like a traffic stop. Shit ain't half as hot, you ain't a rapper, you a laughing stock. Scoop shorty, then I crack at the after spot. A new jack in the city of pookies, it's time to pass the rock. To claim that you the parts of rap, we need a quarterback. Y'all ain't important, even shorties ain't endorsing that. Back on my bullshit, Mayweather, it's tourist season. I'm bored of beefing, I heard you niggas, you bored of decent. A student to the game until I started teaching. I'm in the wake of my prime, AK, I caught him sleeping. I took a beat and get the win just like when Rocky in. Cocky, so the thought of competition's hard to comprehend. Kill mics, only the stand left. Broke into this shit and pulled off with it, that's grand theft. A sharp shooter with infinity rounds. Open fire when you get behind my enemy lines. You know what goes in. Number one son, we've been chosen. Golden, about to fuck it up, bring a Trojan. Holding, got my brother's backs, never folding. Frozen, the faces looking back at the shows in a showman. Never shy away for a moment. Independent made, check the Ronin. I roam in, my own lane like in bowling. Only way to win in this game is to keep the pen rolling. Ayy, about that act, we don't be talking.
talking long. Internet threats, we don't get into that. We pull up at the block you want. A second at the intersect, see who we've been plotting on with choppers drawn. Hopping out of vans, big as soccer moms. The only moves to make is ones to profit on. When all the people on my side ate just like an octagon. Pass the torch and watch us carry with ease. We rarely fatigued. Extraordinary league of MCs, little nigga.
He literally just shut it down.
We don't need
Did y'all
no
see
that
just
that.
Now?
What? He killed
oh
it. Killed
oh,
it.
Oh, oh, shit. Hey, look. Wait. Hey, he just jumped up out the seat right. And shit.
Wait, no. Go get God. Wait, hold on.
Hold on.
Hey,
hi.
Now.
Hey, hi, man. You got to tell people when it can reach you.
Yeah, tell the people
you know what I mean?
When it can get those bars.
Yo, so I go by A Hi to Have Not. You search me up, A-HIVENAUT. I pretty much have that shit sewn up. So if you can't find anything with the A-Hi, search the Have Not. Man, we everywhere. Spotify, Apple Music, Tidal, YouTube, SoundCloud, all that shit.
All the things.
All that shit.
You know what I'm saying?
Literally everything. You search my name up, you'll see me on the Google search.
Hey, man.
Just click the link and...
Thank you for coming up here, man. And
y'all
gonna
get these bars today.
It's love, man.
All right.
Hey, I appreciate y'all having me, man.
Man,
real.
Let's give it up for my guy, A-Hi, man. Yeah. Hey, A-Hi, man. You know what? Hey. You certified on the bar test.
Certified.
Hey, and I slipped one too, man.
I feel
a little way about that, but you know what?
No.
But
you
know what?
There.
Yeah, I mean, out of 3 minutes and 15 seconds, one bar slip is.
That was like a whole song.
I'll take it.
Yeah. You gave it to us.
I'll take it.
I'm like, man, he was trying to go for the Black Thought record. The 10 minute
Look, that intro. That's why I'm like, I looked at the beat. I'm like, this shit 5 minutes, but then that intro take off once. So I'm like, okay, it's a little deceiving.
So you know what I mean?
I gave you 3:15.
You gave me 3:15. I ain't mad at that. You know what I mean? I'm like, I ain't mad at that.
Next time, I'll have it all in the memory. You know what I'm saying? We stand up, and I'm gonna do this shit. Hopefully, I come back.
Oh, absolutely, man. I'm like,
You're welcome back whenever you want with all the gravy, all the sauce,
absolutely,
all the seasoning.
Absolutely. Fifth Element Hip Hop, y'all. Give it up for them pushing the hip hop scene out here in Vegas and really growing this shit. Man, I respect and appreciate y'all, man, so much. Real talk. And I see what you're doing. Just keep this shit moving, man. Y'all got it going. It's a beautiful thing y'all got going.
Thank you.
Appreciate you.
Thank you so much.
Give it up for A Hot, man.
Yeah.
One more time. You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? Yo, Raymo, anything going on, man?
No, we ain't got much going on. We got a new guest. Let's get him up.
Yo, Miles.
We got hip hop in the building today, y'all.
Yeah.
Yo, we got all kind of
See,
things
because
going on.
We like to add value to our viewers,
definitely,
all right?
Definitely.
So we're gonna make sure that we got y'all covered on both ends of the field, right? So like we got bars for y'all for days. We got another spitter for y'all.
Yo. So
like
right now, man, we
more
about
than
to bring
you
up
want.
Bring up here, man. I have the pleasure to meet this man. First time I met him was at the cookout. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And I'm like, yo, that was my first time meeting him.
Okay.
That was my first time meeting him, man. I'm like, yo, I heard his name in the streets forever. I actually seen him battling when he was like, you know, 16 years old.
Right.
You know what I mean? Eating up a 14-year-old. Right. And I'm like, but the 14-year-old was nice. He would have ate most grown-ups.
You're one of the 17 million people that seen it.
Right. Exactly. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? And it was crazy, though. Because I'm like, yo, you know, seeing him come up there, I'm like, him being a cat from Vegas, you know what I mean? Repping Vegas the way he did, you know what I'm saying? And really, you know, barring out.
Yes, sir.
You know what I'm saying? Radio personality, you know what I'm saying? Host of the cookout, you know what I mean? And a legitimate host of the cookout because I'm like, you got to have bars to be able to host that. Yeah. You know what I mean? I feel like that's a requirement. Yeah. So he ain't got like some little young, little dainty girl who ain't never rapped a day in her life. Mm-hmm. You got a real spitter up there who can tell you like, yo, that shit was weak or that shit was hot. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Definitely brought respect to the game, man. And I'm like, yo, other than that, I'm going to let him talk to his own story. Let's give it up for my guy, Miles Lowe, Fifth Element fan.
Fifth Element, man. Thank y'all for having me, man. I'm glad to be here, man.
Welcome.
Hey, like I said, I want to thank y'all from the bottom of my heart for carrying the Vegas culture on y'all back right now. There's only a few people that are really holding the hip-hop side of Vegas up like that from a media side.
Thank you.
I appreciate y'all for that.
We love it because we love it.
Yeah. Absolutely, man.
That's a special place in my heart. That's how I really start. I started off doing college radio at UNLV.
Right.
And, you know, I always was big on just playing giving as much local love as I can give.
Right.
Because I never got it being a local growing up. To see where it's at right now, to see it being as accepted and as widely spread apart as y'all as it is right now, man, and y'all being at the center of it, man.
Thank you. I appreciate y'all for real, man. Thank y'all for being here.
It's a shift in the culture, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So Miles, man, I'm like, yo, you know, I said a few things, man.
Okay.
But I'm like, of course I ain't touch on everything.
Can I get one of these waters?
Absolutely, man.
Yeah, let me I'll be right back. I'll grab you one.
I ain't want to interrupt. No, you good. I'm sorry.
I'm like, yo.
Should have offered you one.
But I want you to tell the people, man, how you got started in this, man. Mm-hmm. What made you find the love and affinity for hip hop, man, and brought you to this point in your life, man.
I attribute everything to two cars, my mom's car and my dad's car. I appreciate you, Slim. I'm so proud of Slim too, by the way, man. Slim's come along with. I remember from Slim from 88.1 when. Right. To be where he's at now and stepping out as a personality, man. I would love you, Slim, and I appreciate you, man. But my mom's car, my dad's car. My mom's car was she was the West Coast. She's from Cali. Pasadena. So she had the West Coast. She had the Daz, the Corrupt, the Dog Pound.
That's dope.
CJ Mack, you know what I mean? CJ Mack come up here. I was like, oh, CJ Mack got to show up here. Like, you know what I mean?
She put,
exactly. She put me onto that kind of stuff. The real neo soul feeling stuff. The Jill Scott's, Coffee Brown, Kim, D'Angelo, Angie Stone, all that. She got Coffee Brown in the car right now. So like still.
She's still rocking after the party.
After the party, man. Yep.
Straight up.
But my dad's side, my dad was really more the part that I think influenced me more. He's from Jersey.
Okay.
Jersey, so what part?
He's from Newark.
Okay, Newark, word. Baby. I got family in Newark. Mm-hmm.
Where you from?
I'm from Asbury Park, New Jersey.
Okay, got you.
07712. Right.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
He's the one to put me on to the Nas. To y'all was talking about Common B was our theme song.
That album was
ahead of its time, man.
That album was incredible. I was just listening to it the other day.
Who else? AZ.
AZ.
But he also was the first one to really put me on to the local scene too. We was at a barbershop, and y'all might know a guy named Quadir. You remember that name?
Yeah.
Of course we know Quadir. We had bought a Quadir tape back in the day, and my dad played that like, man, nah, this is the sound of Vegas, man. This is what it is. And from then I started really tapping in and loving the local scene. So
Quadir was one of the first ones to really go out there and like have that major advertisement. He was on buses, bus stops and shit. Quadir was everywhere.
Quadir was big at that time, man. So yeah, man, that's where I fell in love with hip hop at, man. Right there, man, right around that Nas time, right around I fell in love with Ether. Steelmatic, Lost Tapes. I fell in love with that, and I remember the first song I ever requested on the radio was Ether. I don't know why, but that's just the song that I stuck with.
Right.
And then from there, like in those kind of music, I went to like the Cassidys and the Jada Kids, and then I started learning that they actually do rap battles like that. So I tapped in with the early Fight Club days. When they was coming on MTV.
Fight Club was ridiculous. Man, I remember that.
International P was hosting. Sirius Jones, I was about to say, man, that dude. Mook was out during on Smack and Lux was in his prime.
Lux, Party Artie, it was a lot of people, man, a whole lot of people.
Yeah, it was crazy.
All the dudes that really paved the way, for this battle scene to be like it is right now. That's crazy.
And I fell in love with it. I found out that they were doing it out here in Vegas. And one of my big homies just signed me up. He paid my entry fee. They're like, man, okay, bring him in. And you know, if he shows up and earns his respect, he show up and earns respect. And I did that, man. And I took off with it from there. I never took it as serious as I wish I did, but I got good at it. And I got the love and respect because I didn't have a plan for it. I just wanted to do it because I like the sport. And it turned to something I never thought it would, man. It went viral and, you know, it really took me around the world. And I really didn't understand the totality of what it was until I'm this age now and I'm hosting rap battles full of little niggas that are like, man, we looked up to you.
That part.
That's how you my first battle. I just see like Larry was up here, man. Larry tell me all the time, like, bro, my first battle I ever seen was you.
That's what he said.
That's what he said up here.
You know what I mean? Yeah, that's
now look at him. Yeah. You know what I mean? Doing this thing, about to battle tomorrow at the cookout.
Exactly.
And that's why it's such a great thing that I get to put my boy on his first battle. Like, he's also my my best friend. That's his god brother. That's how I met Larry. So I've known Larry. He was playing like Pop Warner football. Yeah, just like fam. So to be able to put together and host his first rap battle, knowing how, you know what I mean? It's crazy when you think about it like that, man.
That's crazy. Hey, Miles, real quick. I just got a message from Seb. He said he apologized. Hey. He couldn't make it.
He said he's going to call off work, man. Yeah. He said he's calling off work.
Yo, you know what? So that's actually what happened. He called off work for the skating rink.
Okay.
And he ended up having another gig. He was already booked for another gig.
Okay.
So.
All good.
Him and King is at that gig right now.
Man, I love them dudes, man. I love them dudes. You know, this is the cool part about where I'm at in my life right now is I got a lot of like little homies like that are coming of age and it's like, oh yeah, tell Miles I said what's up.
Right.
Like, oh, okay.
So, growing up.
Growing up, man, I really grew up out here and you know, it's nothing but love and it's, you know, I'm just grateful for it all, man. Grateful for it all.
I'm like, you can, you know, I'm like, in your music, you can actually hear the love for Vegas, man. Mm-hmm. I'm like, I'm listening to AFC North, and I'm like,
yes, sir.
Hey, I was just talking about it. I was like, man, that song is freaking insane.
Thank you, man. Thank you.
So it's fire. I'm like, the bars on it is fucking incredible.
Thank you, man.
I'm like, the bars
on it. You said some shit on there, man.
I'm like, dude, the I'm like, just going through the albums, the make the world feel.
Mm-hmm. Make the world feel good.
That, yes, sir. That was like a statement. Yeah. It was a statement piece. It was like you was like, you know what? I'm about to talk to people on this one about some of the social things that's going on in the world, and I like the dates on it, like how you put the dates on it. You was like, you was almost telling the story like a diary type thing.
That's
like
exactly how it was.
It was dope.
It was. Like I said, I was in the middle of the pandemic. That's right after the George Floyd shit happened, and you know. I'm the same age as Trayvon Martin.
Right.
So like I'm a senior in high school as the Trayvon Martin trial's going on. You know what I mean? So
it
a lot of that was built up and I finally got a chance to really express. I've always had the chance to express it, but I finally had the time and just a clear enough mind and sat my ass down and said, I'm gonna just make this music.
Right.
I was also cooking up another project called Don't Rap With Me at the time. So I was already moving.
Right.
But once that hit me, man, I just pinned a project in a couple months and you know, that's what it was. And I just put it out and, you know, good reception. I don't know if you know, I make the shirts to say, make the world feel good. That's my merch.
Oh,
I should have brought y'all some, man, but I'm hooked y'all up. I apologize, man.
No, you good.
No home training. but I just got a chance to really go in there and just, you know, let my heart breathe for a minute. Right. And that's not the kind of person I am. I'm really more calculated a lot of the time. Right, so to really just be emotional on the tracks, that was new for me and it felt good.
Hey, and it came across real good too.
Yeah, thank you, man.
Told a real good story, man. And I was like, you know, it made me feel some type of way listening to them dates or whatever.
Me too.
You know, like when you listen to something and it invokes an emotion, that's exactly what those songs was doing for me. I was like, damn, I was like, okay, this is dope. And I was on my way to the studio while I'm listening to them. So I'm like, damn, I'm like, man, I want to go in here and do some shit.
And you really tell that you speaking from your heart and from your soul. You know, like it's apparent when it's real. You know what I mean? And you could really tell that you felt every word that you said, you know, and as a listener, I can appreciate that.
Thank you.
It makes you feel it. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? It's like when it's real, you have no choice but to be just like attracted to it like that. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. And I feel like, I think that's my gift is communication.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I think rapping is the skill, music's the love, that kind of stuff. But the true gift is communicating with people and being able to talk to people and not being bashful and not being over the top either. Cause some people are oversellers, man. Some people got to just find that middle. So, but I mean, I'm radio trained.
Mm-hmm.
I've done radio since I was 18 years old. You know, I used to work in restaurants. So I worked with hospitality. I host these MLK parades. I worked with the kids. So it's just a part of who I am. And, you know, I sharpen that, I sharpened that weapon up a little bit over the years.
That's where I first met you at 88.1.
Mm-hmm.
I brought 6 John up there when you and Slim were doing the bomb squad.
Yeah.
Nice. Yeah. So
6 John.
Shout out to 6 John.
He's doing great.
I think I still got him on Snapchat, man. Shout out to 6 John.
He actually came up here and did his thing on what is that, second, third episode?
I think third episode.
Third episode. Yeah, he came on, he smashed. Yeah,
yeah.
You know what I mean?
Six John.
Yeah, definitely.
I'm surprised you ain't linked with him since y'all in LA.
you man, listen. So the thing about LA is it's, and for those who don't know, I just moved to LA. I work with a brand new first black owned talk radio station on the West Coast, owned by Tavis Smiley. I'm the production coordinator for the station, man. So I came a long way from 88.1 for everybody who's wondering, man. It's a big blessing to be out there. But the thing with LA is I'm still getting my feet wet out there because I got to be focused because this is, I think I've tricked off a lot of opportunities before. Not because I blew it, but because I wasn't aware of where I was at the time.
I'm
aware of where I'm at right now. And it's more than just the money. It's the alignment. It's who you around. It's the opportunities. It's you know what I mean? Where you place that. And I'm placed in a good position, man. So I'm focused up, man. I've been out there about a year. I still haven't really gone out yet.
Nice.
You know what I mean? I don't have no roster of females yet. Like, I'm
yet.
Right.
And that, 'cause it's going to come.
Right.
And they're out there. So I'm a young man, but I'm focused, man.
No, focused on it all, man.
That's a good game right
like,
there.
Be focused
that.
On the bag. I'm like, yo, you get the bag, man. I'm like, yo, I ain't never seen you lose a female chasing a bag.
Man.
You know what I mean? That's just real talk.
You know, I just told my mom, my brother, I had an epiphany the other day. I found out why I'm still single to this day.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I'm not meant to date in this tax bracket.
Damn.
That's what it is.
Boom.
I think that's what it is. I think I got to elevate and get to where I'm truly supposed to be.
Damn.
And start, you know, I'm going to meet her on the yacht. I don't got to meet her on the and struggle together. We're gonna get our first.
You ain't trying to meet her on the SS Minnow.
We're going to get our second million together.
You said good. The SS Minnow.
But that's real talk.
She helped me get my second million. I helped her get her third. Like that's, yo, that's the story I'm
finna
have.
That's a mindset thing, man. Yeah. That's a, you know, water seeks its own level. Mm-hmm. So I'm like, yo, it's just you just ain't that right now. They're like, dang. Well, no, you looking for that one, you know what I mean? That's going to be up there when you get up there, you know what I mean?
I mean, I'm not, how about this? I'm not chasing, I'm attracting.
Right.
So if you're going to come with me up and you go along for the ride, you got to hop on and hop in orbit.
Like I said, man, if they ain't on what you on, then you know what I mean?
Exactly.
You keep it pushing.
Mm-hmm. Pimp named Slickback said, choose who choose you.
Amen.
Hey, that's a good segue into, okay, so tell me about you coming from the perspective on that song, Friends. Because you was like, I like how you was like, yo, man, y'all not my friends. These not my friends. Like, you know what I'm saying?
So, Friends is... I wouldn't say specifically my story, but it's a story everybody knows a little well. Knows the story of, hey, wrong place, wrong time. You know, you with your friends and they end up going somewhere. Now you end up taking the fall for it because you're not in the place you need to be at. My role has never been, I've never been the gangbanger. I've never been the weed head. I've never been the one to turn up and pop. I've always been the one that spread love and show up and I'm neutral and all, and I'm cool with everybody.
Right.
But my people aren't always like that.
Right.
You know what I mean? So I told a story about a young man linking up with his people because they called him. Hey, man, I need your help on something. And just show, man, whatever you need, I'm there. Let's go. And then you end up in some shit that you can't get out of.
Right. So, you know what I mean? And that's usually how it happens.
That's how it happens.
You know what I mean? They call you up. Hey, bros, I need you for this or whatever, whatever. And you be like, yeah, that's the homie. You don't want to look like you letting the homie down.
Right.
So you show up.
Especially when the homies are there for you.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? I've had homies be there for me through hella shit. through thick and thin or some shit, man.
But,
so,
you know, it's funny because I'm like, you know, if the homie is really the homie, he ain't gonna put you in no shit.
And that's what I'm saying. It must be difficult. You know what I mean? To have to navigate through like that code. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's so strict. You know what I mean?
But they're not like, they're the same age as me and they're going through life same way I am.
Right. Right,
they
right.
may not be where I'm at mentally. They may not be where I'm at financially. They may still be in the trenches and that may be just their life story. They may not have their parents. I'm lucky. I still got both my parents.
Right. That part.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I got homies who've never met their biological parents, been an adult their whole life,
right?
You know what I mean? So it's you just a product of your environment.
You know what's funny is like, you know, I've had homies be like, nah man, this ain't for you because we about to do something and you got bigger things planned for you.
Right.
Like we can see something in you that ain't in us. We thugs. And I'd be like, you know, that's a homie that's looking out for you. It might seem like at the time, like, ah, oh, man, y'all niggas trying to play me. But then I'm like, if you got a homie that's wise enough to say that to you, then you know what I mean? I'm like, you got to listen to that. I'm like,
that's love.
They wiser than you think they are.
You know, the thing is, though, my homies were like that. I've always been like that.
Exactly.
But the thing is, though, they still human, too. And who am I to not be the friend that they need me to be, or they think they need me to be at the time right. when they call on me.
And at the time, right. people, you're not thinking of the long range effects of what's going on. You're thinking about what's happening right now, yeah, trying right now. To solve the situation
hey, bro,
at hand right now.
Hey, man, I got caught at the light. Somebody got my chain, man. Oh, what? Pull up, man. What? What's exactly. the move? Man, hop in, man. We going back to the crib. Okay, cool.
We're not going to the crib. We already loaded up. We already strapped up. We know where homie stay at. Oh, we got... Yeah. You know what I mean? And yeah. that's an exaggeration of a story. Cause that right. doesn't happen to everybody every day. But
right.
still, you know what but I mean? You never know what you're going to get into when you step out that house.
But that's a real possibility, though. It's funny because it's an exaggeration, but it's a possibility.
Yeah.
It's like
at
a
the same
real
time.
One. You know what I mean? That ain't mm-hmm. no fake shit.
Yeah, you man. Know? So I yeah, that was my song, though, man. I loved making that one. That one was that was fun to make. Mm-hmm. That was a fun one to perform. People still love when I perform that track. So yeah, shout out friends, man. Shout out to my boy Noise too, man. Full Circle Core Music Group, man. My boy Noise is the producer on about 95% of my tracks, man.
You know what I like, man? Not. I like Maserati.
Maserati, wow. Yeah.
Maserati is hard as hell.
Yeah.
Hey, I was knocking that shit. I was
Maserati.
Like, I was like, this shit go up, wow. bro.
You know, I have a love hate. First of all, I hate my own voice.
Mm.
I'm gonna be real. I'm very insecure man. About my
you
own.
You don't
voice.
Have a bad one though. I'm like, yo,
and I acknowledge that. Like, I accept it, but when you, if I'm self conscious about it, right. and I do music,
right,
and I do radio, mm-hmm. and I talk all day, and yeah. I do videos, and I rap battle, and I always hear my voice. That's always just the part that I just can't deal with.
Right.
So whenever I listen to my old tracks, especially as I age to get where I'm, like, you know, how my voice changes. Plus hearing like where we were at on like a mixing level, like right. I can sit up there and critique it all day, all night long. But I remember the reason why I love it though. Is I remember how strong we felt as we were making that track, man. So to hear you say, man, I was just bumping that track in 2022.
Man, that shit was
that
hard.
Means a lot to me.
I don't give a shit what nobody say. You could throw that mug on right now.
Mm-hmm.
That is gonna
joint
go.
Is hard.
Period.
I was mm-hmm. like, yo, I'm listening to that shit. I was like, yo, this Maserati is hard. Like, I rewound it. I was like, hold up, man.
Yeah.
I got through half the first verse. I was like, hold up.
Yeah.
I was like, yeah, start
nah,
that
but
over.
That AFC North. Oh, my God. Oh,
yeah.
So, like, you on your... Instagram, you have the one with the lyrics,
yeah.
and I screenshot this because I just had to say this one. You said, "Man, it's hard being the woke one."
The only one scoring, get bothered me when I'm open.
Yep,
they guarded me, and I'm stroking from hard and deep in the ocean.
This dream takes guts,
heart
arteries,
and devotion.
Yeah. Like that's so true.
Yeah. Yeah.
So much truth in these bars.
You know, and that's why I feel like I'm at my. I wouldn't say I'm at my peak, but I think I'm at a place where it's like I gotta go as hard as I gotta go because I'm transcending into a level where I'm pushing out. I mean, before I left Vegas, I was big on like Jay. I got back on my super lyrical shit. I got back on like my Jay Electronica,
right?
What up?
Griselda,
right?
Fonte, mainly a lot of Fonte, you know what I mean?
Like Fontigolo.
Yeah, Tigolo for dope. Like I dug through everything, man. But and
Fonte's still one of my favorites.
Oh yeah.
Me too.
But but that's because I felt like I hadn't updated my core of right. lyricism in a minute.
Right, right.
You know what I mean? So I really mm-hmm. sat and challenged myself, but I knew where I was going in life and I always been authentic, so I wanted to be authentic.
Mm-hmm.
So I just started telling a story about where I was at that time. I took it from talking about my parents. So I went from talking about my brother and he's had a new baby. Shout out
right.
shout out my niece August, man. That's my first niece. Shout out to her.
No.
And that's new for us as a family. To get into, you know, talking about the homie who was locked up, who I just sent a letter to because I wrote it at my cousin's graduation. Like just real life shit that you can't make up. You kind of got to just tell the story as opposed to right. create the environment. And, right. That's just the line that came right there. So I appreciate the fact that that's the one you want to screenshot.
Yeah. It made me feel something when I heard it, you know? So I was like, wow, I just got to share that with
Thank
him.
You. And I even said right there, if I don't give you the chills, I failed as I write this.
As I write this,
you know what
that's
mean?
Another thing.
And
yeah.
that's me putting, like I said, I listen to my old song so much right. that's one of the ones I want to listen to and be like, damn, that's for you, Miles.
Right.
If you didn't get the chills 5 years from now, Miles, then you right. failed as you write this, you know.
Right.
So I'm thinking more.
He said,
I'm definitely thinking
more. A message to yourself. A
message to myself, man.
Nice.
Market X.
Nice.
You know what I mean? And that's because, like I said, I listen to so much music that it's like, damn, I've heard artists at their lowest.
Right.
You know what I mean? You hear the hot shit, but I've heard
they throwaway tracks. I've heard, right. You know what I mean? They're freestyles when they get on the radio and it's like, okay.
Right.
There's some X's on in the ground that you wait for somebody to follow the track, the path and find.
Right.
You know what I mean? Like there's some crazy shit, but there's some dope shit that just never gets the love and the plays. And I feel like even if my music ends up being that, my nigga, somebody somewhere is going to find AFC North in 5-10 years and be like, oh, okay, I see where Miles was at 26 and 27. I see where he was at when he moved to LA. I see what he did for Vegas. Mm-hmm. I see why he went so hard here and there. So
I'm like, speaking about going hard for the city, man. Yes, how'd you link up with Gas and doing the cookout?
Man, so I've known Gas since we was in college.
Okay.
Yeah, went to UNLV. He was playing football. Gas is actually my first ever music video I shot. Yeah. And he was producing and rapping at the time, and he came up to the radio station.
Right.
One of his boys, Smooth. And we got the tracks played and did a little sit-down interview with them, and we just been locked in ever since. And, you know, as the culture, as we grow in the culture, we still linked up and we tap in every chance we get. But he got his space, and he's like, man, I want to start doing rap battles.
Mm.
And I want it to be authentic rap battles, and who else would be more authentic to be the host than you?
Right.
And he's like, man, is that something you want to do? And at first I was like, eh, I don't know. I'm all the way in LA. I don't know if I want to, but everything in me was like, man, nah, this your city, man. Like,
right.
Take that trip. Spend that money. Get off your ass and go, and you know, go tap back in with home. So, right. And
almost
I
like
love it.
Completing your cipher too. Bring that all the way back around.
Cipher's complete. Exactly, man. And they all are sitting there like, man, I can't wait for you to jump in. When you gonna hop in? I'm like, man, I'm not hopping in, man. I'm here for y'all, man. My love for wanting to battle isn't where it once was, man. I got taken advantage of on a lot of the money side of the battle. Mm-hmm. So it's like, but guess what? Now I'm gonna make sure y'all don't get taken advantage of.
Right.
I'm gonna make sure y'all are good. Like, I love Gas. Gas, my man.
Right.
But you know what I mean? If he ever does something wrong to the artist, by all means, I'm sticking up for the artist. That's where I come from. So I'm the perfect blend, I feel like. I think I was the perfect choice.
Right. And I'm like, how you feel when you see like the artists in the city going up, like a Young Nito and a Kamikaze and Jay Fence and all these cats that's battling right now. And you be like, damn, like they be coming up with some saucy ass bars.
Yeah.
So how you feel about that, man?
It's elevation. It's the next level, you know? Shit, if Fats was free, he'd be out there still rapping too. You know what I mean? He'd still be able to rap. Free Fats.
Yeah, free
Fats. You know what I mean?
Man.
It's like we've never had a shortage of rappers in this city.
Right.
Never on any type of scene, from the battle scene to the east side, to the north, to the west.
Yeah.
To there's always been somebody who can rap. So it's just it's just their time to rap, man. I feel like we'd be doing a disservice if we didn't keep providing that platform for them.
Nice.
So yeah, you got your songs too. That's why I'm glad they got a plan for what they're doing.
Right.
They're not trying to just be battle rappers. They already got shit that they're doing. And they're coming to battle. So they're learning to battle.
Right. That's what's dope.
You know what I mean?
That's
so we can cultivate that. We can groom that. We can see what y'all dreams are, where y'all want to take it, and push y'all in that direction.
Right. So in the last battle.
Mm-hmm. It was crazy. Last battle was crazy.
so tell me what battles did you like the most?
Last one?
And yeah, out of the last one.
Okay. Let's start at the top, man. Fence and Kamikaze.
Fence and Kamikaze.
I feel like I think Fence won that battle.
You do?
I think Fence won that battle.
Okay.
I'm going to say he won it easily, but that doesn't mean Kamikaze didn't. I think Fence just edged every round. So it's three edged rounds to no edged rounds. But Kamikaze would have won against anybody else.
I feel like Kamikaze won that battle. When I was sitting there, I was like, Kamikaze was nice with that shit.
It was nice.
I ain't saying that Fence was weak at all.
It felt like Fence had a smack URL type battle. That's how it felt. Okay. Like being right there in front of the stage, like, oh, this man is, he's talking to this man. He's cooking. And the reason why I told Kamikaze, man, I'm so proud of him because, and it's the cool thing about when they come and holler at me about shit is that I'm watching from a different perspective. I'm looking at it from a former battle. And I know how it is to stand in front of somebody who's an actual battle rapper and they're on one and they're cooking.
Right.
Word up.
And you still got to keep your composure. Can't make a face.
Military
bearing. Military. And still
come back and respond.
Yeah.
Not stumble. Not because if Kamikaze, not Kamikaze, the offense would have stumbled, Kamikaze would have won that battle. Kamikaze was on his ass the whole time.
The whole time.
But it's just, I just don't think Fence didn't let up from start to finish. No, and he didn't cuss, man.
Yeah, he did.
And he promoted a gospel concert at a rap battle, bro.
not one cuss word.
Yeah, man.
But the bars was freaking insane.
He's different, man. He's different. But Kamikaze, I feel like Kamikaze's on that level, though. He showed me that, man. Okay, you're right there.
Yeah.
And ain't nobody who we named today that's going to walk over Kamikaze just because you're that good of an artist, man. So I'm proud of Kamikaze.
Nito Jukasa.
Nito won. I told Jukasa, like, man, I don't think there's nothing you can do against Nito from the pen.
Right.
Because Nito's just, I sat and talked to him a few times. Like, his mind is you know what I mean? Like, it goes somewhere with the rap.
Shout out Nito.
Shout out Nito, man. Yeah. Proud of that young dude. But
me too.
I knew it was his battle to lose, but I didn't see how he would lose it. I thought Jukasa might have probably, he had the experience. Right. So that probably would have carried him, and he could have fought with that. But I don't think, lyrically, I thought it was going to be what it was.
Yeah, it was not. Yeah. Yeah. There was no way. I thought Jukasa was going to do better than what he did, to be honest.
Well, here's the thing. You got to understand who Jukasa. I know Jukasa's first battle was a month after my first battle. So he's been back from Ahad days.
Mm.
You know, so I knew what to expect from Jukasa from the first time I saw him walk in the building.
Right.
I knew he was entertaining. I know what he brings to the table. But right. I knew lyrically, you're not that.
Right.
That's not what you are. You're a lot of things. But that's not what you are. Some people are bars and can't perform.
Right.
Can't control the crowd. Don't have a good enough stage presence. Their voice gets weak. My boy Keith Smooth, his voice was going the whole time. It's like, nah, man, like, work on that.
So, speaking of battles or whatever, you know we about these bars on this show right here. You know what I'm saying?
Of course.
And we got this thing called the bar test. And
it's that time?
Yeah, man.
It's time.
Let's do it, man. It's
do
that time.
Time to eat.
I'm like, we already know what you do. If you haven't looked up Miles Low, man, go look him up right now. You can catch him 17 million deep on that battle. You know what I'm saying? And his bars was just as nasty back then as they are now. You know what I mean? Yo, Slim. Yo, run that for my man.
Cue him up. Let's go.
Hey, man, at Miles Low Music, by the way. Instagram, Twitter, YouTube.
Miles Low Music.
Everything, man. I'm outside, man. Vegas, what's happening? Hey, Fifth Element, what's happening?
I was at some of those Ahab battles, too, in the gym over there. Downtown. That shit used to be crazy when Danny Myers was over there.
Yep. Yeah. Did you ever get a chance to see J. Scott battle there?
I don't remember the names. It's been a while. It's been
J. Scott, he was the young homie. He was,
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Oh, shit. I'll come back to J. Scott. RIP J. Scott, man. It's Miles Low.
Miles Low about to eat. On the Fifth Element. Let's go.
See, a lot of these niggas, man, they do other shit than rap. I rap first and do everything, man. That's what I do. That's who I am. That's what I pop out like. But y'all, I'm Miles Law, representing North Las Vegas, man. This Fifth Element podcast. Shout out DJ Slim. Let's get this shit, man. Yo. Heavy is the crown that be sitting on my dome piece. Nigga, get your money right. Don't care what the hoes think. Woo! I'm getting love to the nosebleeds. From Las Vegas to Leimert down to Long Beach. Know I had the city on the string with my last drop. And I've been the face of my team like the mascot. Ooh.
Run it back. Let's go in.
Yo, I proved the critics wrong once again. I'm authentic, raw, cynic. Y'all image wasn't enough to win. They trust me with it cause I never let these suckers win. Felt like we just got off a run, but now we up again. I understand that this is exactly how we planned it. Can't rep Vegas if you never chance it. The dice is too hot now and the chips is too high to throw the hand in. Y'all get away my home court advantage. When I step on the court, it's like magic. A student of the game, making sure y'all don't get more than y'all average. I'm trying to stay balanced and keep my peers hopeful about their talent, but secretly I'm hoping for a challenge. I'm greedy now, I'm sipping martinis out of chalice. Sit down that rabbit hole with Alice, came back, they saw my axle. Go Google map it or go check the atlas. I ain't no trick, but shit, we in the hat trick. That's three X's laying on the mattress. That's me, early riser, late sleeper. Darrell Revis off straight reefer. Nigga the gatekeeper. I know it brick by brick, etched it in stone. I call the play script by script, X's and O's. You wouldn't see no shit like this out of Mahomes. A lot of niggas gonna be pissed now that I'm
home. I used to be the man that got dissed out for the song. Now the only place I ever sit now is the throne. FCC, nigga, on me. Yeah, we cracking again. And my city happy just to see me rapping again. And my niggas got me glad to see me back in this bitch. I say don't forget about me, we ain't lacking again. We back in this bitch, attacking again. No defense, we eating until we back in the win. Life a habit, if it happened once, it can happen again. Fifth Element, it happened once, it can happen again.
Six, seven, eight, nine.
That's the lightest I'm coming all year, y'all. Till 2035.
If it happened once, it can happen again.
If it happened once, man, it can happen again, man. I really rap, man. Listen, man, that's the lightest I'm coming till I'm 45 years old. I promise you that. Every other time you see me from here on out, you be like, okay, cool. That's that nigga right there, man. So, yeah. I don't know, man. I'm going to say it like this, man. I feel like personally, and I love this city. I think I'm the best rapper in the city lyrically, bro.
Hey, yeah,
that's how I feel.
You got to. It's a competitive sport.
Yeah, man.
You supposed to feel.
Okay, if you don't, then it's something wrong. Yeah. You're not thinking right. Yeah. If you don't feel like you're the best at doing what you do, you're not thinking right.
Yeah, man. I think that's where I stand, man. And I challenge anybody to come to Fifth Element and try to prove it, man.
There it is.
That's what I feel, goddamn.
Y'all got the challenge. That's what I say, man. Come to Fifth Element and try to prove it.
Y'all just heard it,
man. Look, man, and. I don't know, man. Whoever say they want it, man. Whoever say they the best, man. I would love to come back and reprove that I am the best, my nigga. I'm bar heavy these days,
hey,
man.
We will be here to record it for posterity.
Thank y'all, man. Thank you.
All right.
But before we go, though, man, like I said, Jay Scott, man, that was my little homie, man. He's actually a year younger than me to the day. So he was really like a little brother to me, man. And his first battle in A-Hat. Was a tryout battle, and he had came up to me like, oh, braces and everything, man. Tall, lanky, 18-year-old kid about to be a freshman in high school. Oh, you're Miles. Oh, man. Yo, you going to peep my battles? I'm going up. Yeah, for sure. Calm down, bro. I'm here. Yeah, for sure. We good. Cool. Went up there and slayed two people in the first night. And he was on his way, man. Unfortunately, he didn't live that long. R.I.P. J. Scott. And, you know, I just feel like that's the spirit I bring to the cookout. Is like, damn, my nigga Jay Scott is the one who's supposed to be on Smack, but unfortunately, he's not going to be the one to make it to Smack.
Right.
So as I'm watching these young cats, man, I'm like, yo, y'all got it. So I'm the same energy I put into him and the same love I showed him is the same love I'm showing everybody on the cookout, man. So be sure y'all tap in with the cookout.
Hey, did he pass through gun violence?
Tomorrow.
Was it gun violence?
No, it was suicide.
Suicide.
Damn. Suicide. Yes, sir.
988 is the new suicide hotline number, man. 988.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, man.
Thank you for putting that out there for our
Miles,
viewers.
Tell the people where they can reach you at, baby.
Listen, man, at Miles Lil Music on Instagram, on Twitter, on YouTube, on Facebook. You know, your girl got my number. Just type in Miles Lowe in the contacts, man. I'm not hard to get in touch with, man.
I'm dead.
Man, tap in with KBLA 1580, man. Talk Radio Los Angeles, man. It's a good conversation, man. Just go to college one time and switch your environment up. Step out your comfort zone. Tap in with KBLA. We got shows all over the place, man. We got a show in New York coming up August 3rd. Not too many people get to travel out this city and perform. We actually get paid to travel a lot this last year or so. So shout out to Mike Xavier. Shout out to Hip Hop and Poetry. We'll be out there in
shout
New York
Mike
with him.
Xavier, absolutely.
He's the plug. Shout out FCC, Full Circle Court Music Group, Vic Smith,
Boy
Noise. Shout out to whole Northtown. Shout out to my boy DJ Slim. Shout out to Fifth Element. Shout out to everybody,
Make the world feel good.
Damn it.
I mean, yo, Ramo, man, let's get our allies out the way, baby.
Man, shout out Katie to Migo, Two Tone, and Mad Records Recording Studio. Pull up on them for all your mixing, mastering, production, and rehearsals. They doing it all over there, located 15 minutes away from the Strip at 1020 East Charleston Boulevard. Reach out to Tone Does Music on IG or Mad Records _LV on IG. They'll take care of you over there. If you're into tarot and oracle readings, holler at Wisdom Mood and Guidance on IG or wisdommoodandguidance.com. She specializes in tarot oracle readings. And if you need that fly cut and we'll get you ready for the weekend, holler at Q at the Barbecue Shop.
Q.
They're located at 2077 North Jones.
Yes,
they
sir.
Say they're taking all fades
taking
over
all
there.
Fades.
And we are out.
Yo, Book, take us out, baby.
Book! I like your bucket hat, Book.
white bucket hat gang.
White bucket hat gang.
F-Media.
1, 2, 3, 4.
And we out.
Bye,
we
y'all.
Out.